Yeah, I'll say yesterday, but this meat, I smell absolutely gorgeous. Best place, food. I was here last night and I had an oval sandwich, an egg sandwich, but I just had to get it because the way you prepares the food is delicious. You get some falafel as well, which is like some crunchy stuff. And cooks that on the oven as well, not many people do. Look at that. I'm vegetarian because I love animals, but just the smell of this. I have to be for my cheat day, I have to have a one-off, and this is the perfect place to come for that kind of stuff. This is what I love. I'm covering like kind of mysteries, like understanding what this says. It's, if you can understand, translate this, you can write in the comments. This is right near the cathedral that you saw in the pictures when I first saw Petropolis. I wanted to come in, looks like the perfect place for Lara Croft, Nathan Drake style adventure I was looking for, but it's just a town, a European kind of town, when really all the best adventures are in the outskirts, in the nature. Pedro de Telegrafo, Pedro de Gavia, all those adventures look so time to return to that real name. My favourite ice cream place, what it's called? Chiquino. So yeah. Usually have really nice ice creams here, like you can see there, the mint, the grande. And the mint one, I asked for the mint one, but they're really stupid, they can't understand a thing. I swear Brazilians are retarded, they can't understand a word you say. Even though I ordered specifically mint, I still don't understand. I know it sounds kind of racist, but yeah, everyone's been too nice to them, but they are, like, they can't, so slow, it's unbelievable. Even though you explain specifically what you want, they still can't get it right, even though I speak properly. Usually here they sell the nicest ice creams on, but yeah, it's alright, it's not bad, like 5 out of 10, but I wanted the mint one. It's so stupid, it's so spoiled and stupid, I can't stand the thing. But yeah, I think they like that in themselves. I think it's okay to get along, like the girl I met in Rio de Janeiro. If you meet them abroad, if they're on holiday, that's the best. Because they don't have to obey society, they're not protected by the moment. Like, the parents or the friends say, oh no, you can't have pleasure, you can't have pleasure, and I can't, I need to control you. That's the way it's all, that's all of society for you, especially by social media. But yeah, the girl I met from South Carolina, as Santa Catarina, she was from Rio de Janeiro. She was in Rio de Janeiro, and she was really receptive, really nice. A lot of girls are really receptive, it's just the parents and everything, and other friends, they usually get jealous, really protective. Damn, this is lush. Then you have a coffee shop over here where they have croissants. See, what else should I say? What other truths should I talk about? Well, I haven't made a day off here. But I've never had a day off, I've always been training. I keep saying I'm going to have a day off, but I at least train for about an hour. I found a park. We can do some pull-ups and some chin-ups. But yeah, I met a few girls there that I didn't get a video, and they're just really receptive, really, really cool. But I think I'm looking towards meeting like the 10 out of 10 that I met online, but she lives like in the outskirts. Like, I think the 10 out of 10s do live in places like this. If you're looking for a really hottest Brazilian girl, they live in the less stressful places, because places like the main cities, they kill, the stress kills everything. And it makes them really stressed out, and they just follow society, what society says, and getting likes and everything. And they're just all about being fake and looking for Instagram and looking after money. But here, they're away from society. They kind of cough, so they're here. So if you want to find a 10 out of 10, you'll find them in places like this, where they're really focused on school and being chill. But yeah. Been even here, the parents would be kind of protective, but the girl I met 10 out of 10, I think she lives in the mountains, kind of in it, the Hollywood Hills kind of stuff. So yeah. But I didn't meet her, I met her on Instagram, but she had like the perfect, like I said, I've never met a 10 out of 10, but if I had to see a 10 out of 10 in Brazil, it would be the girl I saw on Instagram that lives in Petropolis. But the chances of me running into her are pretty slim, even though it's a pretty small city. But I'm sure if I lived here, this is a place where if you lived, you could get probably any hot girl, because living here is kind of easy, because everywhere's really small. If I worked out here every single day, I would become famous, like, within a week, because everyone knows everybody. But in Rio de Janeiro, the main city, I'd become infamous. People hate me just for being gringo. You know, you can't become famous. You can't have a foreign guy becoming famous. But here, they're more receptive towards Europeans. But yeah, here's a good place if you want to get girls. Like, it's the same as Paraguay. If you spend like a year in Paraguay going out every single Friday night, you would either become infamous or famous, and get every single, you know, hot girl. Even becoming infamous is good. I could probably become infamous because I end up saying the truth. Because I don't care what people think, you know, but Paraguay, everyone cares about what people think, which is the bit. Paraguay would be perfect if that wasn't the case. But yeah, the 10 out of 10s are really responsive, even though they'll be shy at first. But usually the 10 out of 10s are always with their. If you approach them on Instagram, they'll be responsive, or if you approach them on their own, they'll be really responsive. Even though they're a bit shy at first. But yeah, if they're with a friend or family, which usually are, the friend or family would be like so protective of them. You can't have pleasure, you can't have a good time, and I can't. You've got to be at my miserable level, that kind of attitude, which is run by all society. Yeah, we're heading now to the centre again. And that's it, Petropolis. Not much adventure, things to do, see. But yeah, I met a few girls yesterday when I first came here, when I just arrived. I was pretty stinky because I was up all night. Yeah, that's the main park. Yeah, I met a really nice girl when she led me towards the park yesterday and towards the museum. Here we have a Japanese-style bridge. So yeah, it's beautiful, but we need to progress. We need something to do. We need to become rich and famous, we need training, we need adventure, we need mountain climbing, and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, usually the white girls here are usually really kind of receptive. Yeah, there's schools everywhere, schools and colleges everywhere, so here's a good place, like Cordoba. Cordoba's a college town to get college girls. And same thing here, it's a good place to get college girls. They're really open-minded, not stressed out, so if you approach them, they won't be so nervous and so tense. I mean, obviously the Brazilians will be a bit nervous because they're nervous because the guys here, they're used to Brazilian guys, and Brazilian guys are crap. They treat them like shit. A lot of them do anyways, a lot of them on the street. If, like, you've seen them, they're always high on cocaine, high on drugs, high on coffee or whatever, and they'll follow, 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 spot them around. I went out with a red-headed girl from Ipanema. She was really rich, really well put together. She's seen a blackish kind of guy. She went out with one night, tried to rape her in a car. And they think every guy's like that, so they got it in their head, so that makes them really nervous. But obviously us British, us American guys, we're not like that. You know, we have rules, we know we'll get arrested and killed straight away. Or, you know, we control our anger, we control ourselves and focus it. A lot of us do anyway, but everybody's different, but you do have a lot of them. That type here in Brazil. A lot of the, I don't mean to be racist, but the African type, in Rio, they're kind of high on drugs and high on cocaine and everything. They're always shouting, like subhuman types. I mean, I know it sounds kind of racist, but like I was here in, like I met a guy, I didn't realise that until I met two guys in my hostel last night from the Netherlands, and I could actually speak really chill with them for the first time in 5 years. I could actually relax and just totally speak like really chill, really relaxed. But usually in Brazil here, they look at you like, you know, they hate you, you know, just for being white. And you can't relax, you can't express yourself honestly, because you're just real uptight, especially if you don't speak good Portuguese. Conversaciones, you know, overseas, a mas conversaciones, like tu dos dias independe espanol, tu dos Portuguese, because morning in Paraguay, morning in Argentina, and morning in Brazil. But yeah, they've lived in Paraguay, lived in Argentina and Brazil. So yeah, and I think I need to go to, I think if I go to Europe, I'll feel a big relief. If I go back to America, I feel a big relief when I approach girls, because they'll have that, you'll be able to relax and talk to them. You know, here they're like, oh my God, a foreign guy speaking to me, oh my God, they get really nervous, and oh my God, what's he going to do? Well, he's going to rape me something, he's going to do something bad. And because they're used to Brazilian guys being like that. But here, it's really cool. Here, you know, it's kind of a bit cool, but they're used to those kind of guys. Yeah, I need to go back to Europe. I think I'll really like it. It's a cool museum. Let's cross over here. Move your hand. And hold the key.
Uh-huh. Key.
Yeah, okay.
Uh-huh. Sim, sim, tranquilo. Uh-huh. 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 Uh-huh.
Yeah, the street is talking about. It's just lost, just like Hollywood. I've seen the movies. But yeah, this is the one that leads to the Hollywood Hills with the huge, lovely mansion. These houses are everywhere around here in the outskirts. Like you have the downtown kind of city, well, not the city, the town, the main avenue. This is the road that leads to Itapaiva, I think you called it. And a girl I met, she said, oh, that's the place to go to for nightclub and dancing. Because not much of a nightlife here in Petropolis. It's too, beautiful colonial town, really relaxed. So they have to get a bus, like a 30-minute bus that way to Itapaiva. Itapaiva, I think it's called, for nightclubs and stuff like that. Yeah, Petropolis is a real, this is like the 11th school I've seen. This is a college. But it doesn't look like one. It's just really cool, really quaint. Asking some of Petropolis, really quaint. They have a cathedral there. And they have this at the park where we're going to do some training to wake ourselves up. Have coffee, and then you have training, and that's all you need. But yeah, this is all Petropolis is. Just college people, school people, which is really cool. Hey guys, got a coffee. Everyone drinks coffee in Brazil, but I thought I'd try it out. Hot. Really lovely morning, nice breeze here in the high in the Swiss Alps, and I'm still in Petropolis, so we're going to have another day's adventure today. But yeah, it just reminds me of like when I was in Europe around Slovakia someplace, in the nice houses here. Just finished this is a nice hostel, Finn Hostel, really nice, just stayed there. And now we're going to check out the rest of the city now, go to the museum, just have my coffee, really strong coffee, this black coffee, so yeah. This little European style place. So, let's guys. Yeah, we're back right dab in the centre again. It's going to go all the way here. Main Avenue. Little miniature Buenos Aires statue. Back in the park. But yeah, I'm not blown away by Petropolis as I was, as I expected to be. I was more blown away by Terrasopolis, by how peaceful it was. This is kind of like a mix, like in the outskirts you have the, like just bear with it before, it was really peaceful, really upper class kind of like Terrasopolis kind of atmosphere, but here, this main street is kind of like downtown Rio de Janeiro again. It's, definitely not as bad as downtown Rio de Janeiro, because that's hell. That's probably the worst place on earth. Yeah, have a lot of hustle and bustle here. You can see it probably getting dangerous at night time, but yeah, still good, but I prefer Terrasopolis. I think you can't really compare, everything has difference. Terrasopolis has the mountains and the cool people come with you and approach you. I don't think people will approach you here, there's so many people, so there's too much hustle and bustle, which causes paranoia, so yeah, people to be more intense, too much noise. But no, it's really, really cool though. Almost as peaceful as Terrasopolis, but we'll go on the outskirts. Probably back at the outskirts, it's more peaceful there. So yeah, grab some food and there's not much to do. Hey guys, so we're in the centre, we've reached the end of the avenue. So this is the main avenue. We've just walked all down, there's not much to see, just shops, a few bars. But yeah, it isn't as peaceful as Terrasopolis. In parts it's more beautiful, but yeah, they have like a lot of African mix people, and I think it's going to get dangerous at night time, where Terrasopolis is just peaceful all the time. It's really a Switzerland kind of place, but yeah, you're reminded you're in Brazil a lot of times, and they have rubbish as well on the side, which never happens in Terrasopolis. But yeah, but I think here is a good place to live, because you have more options, you can live here for a long time. Terrasopolis is too small, you get bored of it. Like I said, it's a bigger place, so they're going to have more people. The more people you're going to have, the more noise you're going to have, the more bullshit you're going to have. And it causes people to be much more conservative, much more uptight. So yeah, it is a bit busy and a bit bustly compared to Terrasopolis. We need to look for a park. We need to find a park where we can train some good food and get some green oil. Hey guys, welcome back to another day, another adventure. I want to spend a chill day today, so what kind of, there's no better day, no better way than spending a chill day than touring Petropolis, or the most peaceful, it's supposed to be peaceful, like Terrasopolis, so really, this is what, I just arrived now, this is what you say, a bus station here, it's hard to walk to, it's just make like main roads, so we're gonna have to get a bus to the central, which is, I dislike, I usually like walking, but people say it's just roads, it's pretty dangerous. Well, it's not dangerous, it's probably too far to walk, because we're not in the centre, so yeah, we're gonna have to get a long bus. But hey, the sun's out, we're high in the mountains, the bus was really lost coming here, we had to climb the mountains, see the beautiful views. But yeah, see, this is a really peaceful city as well, like Pteristopolis, so since we've already done Pteristopolis, we'll do Petropolis now and get a really peaceful day, get some food, get some nice people, meet some nice people and get some good food. So, yeah, really peaceful, really European vibe, I feel really chill now, really relaxed energy compared to this city, so to have a chill day touring this European Switzerland kind of town. It's just like Pteristopolis was. Hey guys, yeah, I'm assuming this is the centre. This is a really cool place where people just come to relax. That's the garden, the museum, and then this is like the main avenue. This is the centre where it meets. The avenue goes this way, all along the streets. Lots of supermarkets, lots of shops, supermarkets there. Rolling Star, really peaceful. And this is the other avenue that leads to the cathedral we just saw. And it all meets right in the centre here, and they have the huge lake, huge river in the middle. Huge lake. And it's really Japanese style. They have like bridges that cross this lake, and it's all Japanese style, like the Japanese gardens everywhere. So it looks like a mixture between Switzerland and Japanese gardens they have as well. And a bit of Costa Rica with the trees, so yeah. But it's got to be more to it than this though. Just find a place to work out and get some good food. Oh guys, look at these colonial style houses. It's beautiful. It looks like, it doesn't feel like I'm in Brazil. It feels like I'm in the nice parts of the United States right now. Like when my granddad grew up. It's amazing. Really peaceful escape. This is just what I needed. I always say I'm going to have a day off. Like these day offs that are going to be chill. I end up getting so much energy and I end up getting the itch, so I need to work out. Even if it's every day, you know. Yeah. I think I'm back at that athletic level where used to work out, train at 8 hours a day. Now I'm getting the itch. Like, I can't just have a day where I'm just like getting in bed or just rest, because I always get the itch, especially being an athlete, you know. I used to train 8 hours a day, almost every single day, so it's really hard. So, yeah. Let's get some training, find some bars, some outdoors, train in the sun, and let's get some good food and meet some good people, and then we'll see the museum tomorrow. But yeah, this is better. I'd probably prefer to live here than Pteristopolis, because Pteristopolis, you could get bored of it within a month, but here, it seems big enough to have nightclubs and meet some girls and everything to get the most of it for about 2 months. Hey guys, welcome to Petropolis! I'm really happy now we just arrived in the central. I'm just taking a bit of this, because this looks really like what country do I look like I'm in? Maybe be Switzerland or Monaco. Yeah, it looks like the Monaco, where they have the Monaco Grand Prix, and it is like that. It's really European, really chill. That kind of feels, like Pteristopolis, it kind of just feels too chill. Like, there's just mountains all around, but not like Pteristopolis. Pteristopolis was epic mountains. I'm not sure which I prefer. Pteristopolis, I've only been here 5 minutes, but compare it to Pteristopolis. This is the main avenue, the main avenida. This is my hotel. And yeah, there's the Greaser Church. And they have mountains all around. Like, it's kind of like Pteristopolis, the way it's high in the mountains, but it's like a ditch, if you know what I mean. So, and here's this little city. So it's like in a valley in the top of the mountains. So it's pretty windy, but the sun is shining, so it's really hot today. Well, it's really, really windy. But yeah, this is the main avenue, it's down there. So it's a lot bigger than Pteristopolis, a lot bigger. So we're gonna have the main avenue is really here, but I just spoke to the lovely Letitia before, and yeah, she's a really nice girl. It's not like really near where you can actually talk and relax to him, but I kind of feel too relaxed at the same time. Like I'm walking around looking a bit dizzy because I don't know where to go, and you know, just too relaxed, if that makes any sense. You know, when you're just too relaxed, it's like, oh, I just feel too peaceful, you know. I just feel like walking really slowly, really lethargic, that kind of feeling. So yeah, when you meet girls, it's kind of like, oh, you don't feel up for meeting girls because you just feel kind of really too relaxed, you know. You feel really peace, But anyways, let's go. The mountains aren't epic as Terrasopolis, but right now I think I prefer Terrasopolis. Just the people are just so nicer. Obviously, I've only been here for an hour, so I can't really tell. Obviously, the city is really nice, but here we have more the kind of a lot. Like in Rio de Janeiro, you have a lot of black people. It's mostly like 90% black. Afro-American kind of mix, and here is a lot of that as well. Leticia was one of the first people that I saw who was like whitish European. I've seen a few. It's like 20% European. It's really cool, really nice people, really chill, kind of too chill. A bit like Terrasopolis, but Terrasopolis, you can't get nicer than Terrasopolis. The people there are just super, super, super duper nice. Like, it's kind of scary how nice they are. Like, they just come up to you and talk to you. But here, you'll have to, it's a bit bigger, so it's a bit much bigger city, which I think that means you're going to have to get more noise. It's going to be people a bit more wary. That's what happens in big cities. That's what I realised in big cities, people just get a bit more wary and a bit more cautious to speak to people, especially foreigners. So here's a bit bigger, so that means there's more people, that means there's more noise. So yeah, Terrasopolis I think is going to have nicer people. But anyways, let's get cracking, let's go and meet some nice people and some lovely food and some lovely architecture. It's a perfect day, just relaxing, walking around on my rest day, Mount Terrace Petropolis. Perfect day, it's like my perfect Sunday. Wow guys, look at this, still in Petropolis. This is the this is probably the second best thing to see in Petropolis because the museum's closed, but we'll go see that tomorrow. But yeah, look how beautiful this is. Just like Switzerland, we're high in the mountains, so it's really windy. The sun's out, so it's pretty warm, but it's still really windy. Yeah, this is already my favourite place in Brazil. Well, I wouldn't say favourite because it's, I mean, the most beautiful, because it's just, doesn't feel like you're in Brazil. It feels like you're in Switzerland or some kind of, like, you have like the Mediterranean kind of architecture mixed with the Switzerland kind of high in the mountains, posh lifestyle. But yeah, here, beautiful people, beautiful everything. It's just amazing. Yeah, I think this is probably better than Terrasopolis. Terrasopolis is good for the people. The people are so nice in Terrasopolis. Yeah, I've already met some beautiful people and just, as you can see, they're really nice, really friendly, really chill. I see people just relaxing here and no one bugging them, there's no dangers here or anything. But yeah, I think it will get a bit dangerous at night time because there are, some kind of favela types around. Only like one or two. But like, I think there's none in there. I think it's all European, high-class kind of people in Terrasopolis, but here it's kind of a mix because it's much bigger. Yeah, this is already one of my favorite places, but you wouldn't say favorite, just it's different because there's no beach here. This has the high class kind of Switzerland kind of lifestyle. But I need the beach, but you can't have everything all in one place. Like I said, because everyone will go there and just ruin it, like I keep saying. But yeah, let's go. This is beautiful. This looks like something out of Legend of Zelda, the Temple of Light. But let's go see the main avenue, which is that way. And that's the long avenue that has all the shops and I don't know if there's a few bars. I asked Leticia, she said there's not a few bars here, but I'll check some out. And that way is more the outskirts and towards the bus station. But yeah, I prefer this to Terrasopolis, but I think I prefer the people in Terrasopolis. They're just so nice and just come up to you all the time. But I think here's more tourism, so they're used to tourism, so they used to get the bad apples and the good apples as well. But yeah, they have the mountains there, not much adventure to do. Terrasopolis is full of adventure to do, but yeah. Anyways, this might be my... Yeah, I really want to live here, but this is bigger. This is much, much bigger than Terrasopolis. So this is the best place to go, for, you know, to meet girls, to meet guys, because there's so much more people, and there's so much more... There'll be so much more nightlife. But yeah, Terrasopolis has the mountains, but we've got the good and the bad everywhere. All right, guys, we're in Hollywood. But it doesn't remind me of Hollywood. It's just like the path that was just down there. So the mansion was just down there. And the path curls and he climbs up and it has these Victorian style, climbs up into the hills and they have these Victorian style lamps and Victorian style houses and it just climbs up into the hills like this. Like if you've seen Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, it's a bit like that. The houses are just absolutely beautiful, so chill, relax. Yeah, this is the outskirts. It's like a small city, Petropolis, because you had the centre before, which was there, like 30 minute walk away. Now we're in the outskirts, just 30 minutes walk. Oh, not even that, 20 minutes. And this kind of climbs into the hills, like Hollywood Hills, where they have these rich houses. Except if it's more Victorian, European style houses like this. yeah, not much of a hill adventure, but say go find some cool people and some food. So yeah, guys, welcome to this is the Hollywood of Brazil, really. The pine trees and the mountains. I've got a really good view. I'll show you a good view later. The mountains in the background over there. When I was up there, and this is the main attraction, the museum we'll go to later, the national park. It's like the Parque Lark in Rio de Janeiro. They have a really nice park, and inside the park is like a little museum. So yeah, just had my coffee, so I'm really happy. I just get really happy after the coffee. Yeah, it looks like a really colonial kind of industrial town. You just got mountains all around, so it's a little tiny city. So they have like a mix of everything. Like, you have the Japanese style gardens here, the river, Japanese style bridges. And then you have the mountains in the background, like Switzerland. And you have the colonial style European, like Montenegro, Monaco. And you have like this guy in a hat here, who's like really European style. And you have these Hollywood Hills type trees. It's just from everywhere. It's really lush. So yeah, we're gonna check out the museum now, but this is really lush. So yeah, I just have, it's really nice when the sun's out. The sun's out and you have like a really nice breeze as well, so you don't get too hot and sweaty, so you can work out. Like, usually in Brazil, Rio de Janeiro or Brazil, everywhere, you used to have like 5 showers a day, but here you can train in the outdoors and you don't really need to shower that much. You just shower like twice a day usually. Because the really cool breeze being up in the hills, up in the mountains, top of the mountains, with the mountains all around, and we're like in a little valley, so you can see a bit of the mountains there. It's really lush. And the Europeans have got a really good reception here, because I'm European, so I've got a good reception, because it's a colonial town, from the colonial times, and we're, you know, a lot of other places in Brazil are usually dominated by the black majority, so they have a real... Sometimes they have a hate for gringos, you know, foreign or white guys. I mean, it's not like England. England is have white, and everyone, or South Africa, you have white and mix, and they mix perfectly, you know, they get along with everyone. But here, they still have a bit of hate for the slavery times in a lot of Brazil. You know, they still have a hate for the foreign, you know, the white guy. Which is understandable with the terrible history that we put them through. Not we put them through, because I'm not responsible. I wasn't born in that time, so it's a completely different era. I was especially my timeline. I'm part Norwegian as well, so yeah. This is but here they don't have for the low intelligent people. They usually have a lot of hate for the white guys in a lot of Brazil, especially Rio de Janeiro, which is mainly black majority dominated. But if you go to Barajuca, the rich places, which has intelligence, and then they realise, you know, that, you know, the people up on these days aren't responsible, you know. We're not related to any of them. But anyways, later, guys. Hey guys, here we got a good view of the mountains over there. I can see a little trail, so that's a good place to might be able to hike up. And the centre's just down there that we were just before. And here they have such nice houses, but check them out. Look at these houses, they're really... It's like it reminds me of when I was back in Europe, or the nice parts of the United States. But check out the houses. Okay, really lush place to live. Really perfect place. Really colonial style house. Look at this. This is amazing. Look at that. It's like a different country. It's amazing. Yeah, I think it's sort of like a little college town. So you find some college girls here, they always go to college. It's a bit like Cordoba. You know, Cordoba in Argentina is a college town. So you find all these school kids, all these college kids, just running around. So yeah, that's the majority of people. It's mainly just a college town, people just to grow up, to learn. Very intelligent people. People are just focused on learning, you know, learning instruments, learning how to become famous, and really close, still close to nature, though. It's not like as bad as like Asunción, where it's full of pollution, and they're not close to nature here, behind the mountains. So they're really close to the sun, really close to the wind. It's kind of windy, got a bit chilly last night when I went for some food. Yeah, these houses all on the street. This is where it leads to like the kind of Hollywood Hills where we were last night. Up there, they have it's kind of like the Brazilian version of Hollywood Hills, but they're Victorian style houses, and everyone's really chill, really well behaved. Kind of a bit conservative, but just still open towards European people, which is cool. Not as much as when I was in Europe. I was in my hostel last night and I met some really cool guys from Holland, and I was just so at ease talking to them. And I realized it's because I'm so used to speaking to Brazilians the past 3 years. It's kind of made me, I don't know, adapt to it. It's kind of made me used to being treated like crap. Not treated like crap, but received like crap, like giving dirty looks just for being white. Because my Brazilian friend did say that cariocas, people in Rio, are the most racist, disgusting, ignorant people ever. Those are not my words, those are the words of a Brazilian. So any Brazilians get angry with me, I didn't say that, those are the words of a Brazilian who escaped Brazil. Obviously not all Brazilians are like that, just a few in Rio and a few around, but you get assholes everywhere. You know, people who are ignorant and stupid, who think everyone's the same, who think, oh, you're a white guy, you're an evil white guy, all this kind of stuff. You get people like that. I mean, you get America. I met a few American white guys who talk about black guys like, you know, there's some kind of different species or something, you know. It's just stupid. It's really ignorant. So yeah, you get people like that all around the world. But this cathedral, we'll check it out actually, because you're allowed to go inside. So we'll check it out. So we're down there at the museum, which is the number one place to visit in Petropolis, just that way. So now we're gonna head to the second best place everyone's saying to visit, this cathedral that's like, yeah, it's like Legend of Zelda, the Temple of Time. So we'll go check it out. Some people say you can walk inside, so we'll go walk inside now if you'd like to take a video. We won't go in this entrance, we'll go in the other one, because it's really epic looking. So yeah, you have the mountains there, just like Teresopolis, but not as epic as Teresopolis. Teresopolis is the best for mountain climbing. I think, is that a trail? It can't be that big of a trail. There's like houses up there. You might be able to hike. Might be an easy hike, but I'm not sure if there's anything worthy of seeing. Yeah, people here are always getting the picture taken. Because this is probably the best number one place to get your picture taken, with somebody standing at the bottom of the stairs, and you have this behind you, which is really epic. So yeah, I was here last night. They had a food truck here. I was here last night to get some egg sandwich, but it's really freezing at night time. But look at this, it's like a different country. And that's the park we were in yesterday to have a view. This is the major thing. When you look at Petropolis, this is the major thing you see. So let's go be Link now and pull out the Master Sword. Be a real nerd. Be a real geek. Yeah, when I wanted to come to Brazil, I looked up Brazil to escape, you know, from society, what society was coming with social media. 2013, I thought, I've got to escape, you know, to nature and everything. I don't know why, just my body was craving it. Maybe it was semen retention or something that was pulling me towards it. This is the picture I saw of the outside of the cathedral, though. So if you look at Petropolis, this is what you see. You can't have this in the centre of Rio because it would just get wrecked and destroyed by the favela types, but it is beautiful. Anyways, I've got to go check out the museum. I might be meeting Patricia, the redhead we met yesterday. It's 2 p.m. So we'll go do some quick training. I'm not bothered about training outside here because it's really cold. So you don't sweat that much. So you don't need to dip in the sea. Usually in Rio or in a train, I use it. Oh, I need to have the sea or have some coconuts. Really refreshing. But here you can just, oh, what a lovely view of the mountains in the background there. See the mountains, focus, there we go. So yeah, I haven't found any bars. Like here, usually you find Santander bars around these bars, silver bars all around Brazil that you can do chin-ups and pull-ups on. That's why a lot of people are ripped, obviously because of the drugs and everything. People use on cocaine are high on coffee so much. But also because of the beach life, people always walk around. Are usually used to revealing, going around shirtless. Except for here in Petropolis, I was in my hostel and I was getting some sun, sunlight, and usually European style towns like this, it's a bit like, they have the same kind of rules as Paraguay, where if you take off your shirt, the guy's like, oh no, put your shirt on. And usually in the rest of Brazil, you can walk around shirtless, because, you know, Brazil is a lot of beach culture, so people are used to having to be ripped, or still trying to look up for the beach. That's why it has a big gay lifestyle. So people are used to walking around in their trunks or whatever. So yeah, so we'll go work out over there, get some bars in the park. They're not working out bars, but just in the park. So we're here in the famous Kafta restaurant. I was watching Podrubinski yesterday, so I needed a falafel sandwich. This is my falafel sandwich to go. Pretty expensive, 35 reals, but really lush, really quality food. Look at all this lovely food. Real vegetarian food like that, really healthy. And the hummus, delicious. Brazil, they have it pretty popular in the south. Falafel and Arabic food, especially in Foz do Iguazu. And the hummus in Foz do Iguazu was absolutely delicious. And all this is, wow, I might get some of that. I've never had some of that. We'll have some of that to go. All this special food, and I'll tell you what it's like. I get that from a trip back, taste it, see what it's like. But yeah, probably pretty delicious.